Hello and welcome back to Bee Monster Laboratory. Today I want to demo and review Makey Makey. It's the invention kit for everyone ages 8 and up. If you like playing games, having fun, and electronics, stick around, let's check us out. To be honest with you, I didn't know where to start this video. There are so many possibilities with this Makey Makey circuit board, you couldn't possibly cover them all in one video. Or ever. So I'm going to start in the beginning, as if you knew nothing about Makey Makey. So I purchased this on Mercari for $35.22 after tax and shipping. You're going to pay for it more other places probably, but you can get this at Amazon, you can get it at Walmart, you can get it on eBay, you can get it at sparkfun.com. But just shop around before you purchase. Now this is essentially a circuit board that is an invention kit, and it's designed to connect everyday objects to your keyboard using a circuit board, some alligator clips, and a USB cable. And it makes this connection by using closed-loop electrical signals, and it'll send that to your keyboard either by keyboard keystroke or mouse clicks. Now this is advertised for ages 8 and up, but you can involve younger children if there's parental supervision, no problem. This has been an awesome way for us to keep our kids engaged while learning about electronics and using their imagination. We have thoroughly enjoyed using this. There we go. So we have some wires, a USB cable, a bunch of alligator clips, and three more alligator clips that were on the front of the box. And some stickers. And instructions. First thing I did was play a video game on my computer by remapping the outputs on the Makey Makey to correspond with the keyboard keys used to operate this game. You can see that I have the Makey Makey connected to balls of Play-Doh, which I'm using as the control keys for this game. Now, Play-Doh is conductive enough to carry an electrical signal, and while I'm grounded, meaning I have the grounding wire connected to my wrist, every time I touch the Play-Doh, it completes the circuit and sends that signal to the keyboard to perform an action within the game. This probably wasn't the best game to use, but it's one that my computer will run. When you're ready to start your project, the first thing you want to do is go to makeymakey.com/pages/remap. And select your device. For me, it's the classic. Now you want to be sure that you have version 1.2 or higher, and you can find that right here on the back of the board, right here at the top. Now make sure your board is disconnected from your computer and then click on start. Now you're going to connect the up and down arrow using one alligator clip. You're going to clip one end to the up arrow and the other end to the down arrow. Now you're going to connect the left and right buttons by clipping one end of an alligator clip to the left button and clip the other end of the same alligator clip to the right button. And once you have the up and down arrows and the left and right arrows connected, you can go ahead and plug it into your computer. In this video, I left a third alligator clip attached to the earth section, which I should have removed. It's not necessary, and it doesn't tell you to do that. Once you plug your board in, remove all the alligator clips from the board. The next screen is a mapping screen where you see the front and back diagram of your Makey Makey board, and below that you see a keyboard. In order to map the buttons from your keyboard onto your Makey Makey board, you need to take your left hand and pinch a set of two holes on the bottom strip of your Makey Makey board labeled Earth. Now using your right hand, you can press the left and right arrows to navigate across the diagram to the corresponding button on your board that you want to map. Once you've highlighted the button that you want to map on your board, you press the down arrow. Once you're on the keyboard diagram, you can press any of the four arrow keys to navigate to the keyboard key that you want to use. Once that key is highlighted, you can press click to map it to your Makey Makey board, and press save when you're done mapping your keys. These are your earth connections on the front of the Makey Makey board, also known as your ground connections. And there are six on the front. If you need more than that, there are six extras here on the back, and these little ports right here.
You can map 6 of your keyboard buttons on the front of your Makey Makey using the 4 arrow keys and then the space and click button. If you need more than that, there are extra ports on the back along both sides, the ones labeled WASDFG, and on the right side, the ones with the up arrow, down arrow, left, right, and then the click buttons. So there are plenty of extra connections that you can make. I haven't had a chance to use this port up here at the top, but it looks like you can connect another circuit board to this board. You see the ports here have a 5 volt plug here and a ground plug and a reset plug or port, and also key out and MS out. So it looks like you can connect other circuit boards to this. I really like all the extra ports on the back. It really expands the usefulness of this Makey Makey board, and it allows you to create so many more things. These are the jumper cables that the kit came with, and you're going to plug these into the ports or pins or whatever you want to call them here on the back. But I find that they're a little snug, so I used my breadboard jumper cables and they fit perfectly, so that's what I use. And these jumper cables are dirt cheap on Amazon. You can buy a ton of them for $7-$10 or whatever, and I think that they really do work better than the ones provided. And to extend the connection from the back of my board, I am going to use alligator clips on the other end of my jumper cable here. This is a controller that I created out of marshmallows, a tomato, and an orange. But I had to swap out the tomato and the orange because they got pretty nasty after a while. It started leaking, but anyway, it does work, and the sensitivity was quite amazing. I just want to show you the controller that I used for this game, Overcooked 2. It's basically a bunch of marshmallows taped down the leads here. We've thoroughly enjoyed using this Makey Makey board, and we haven't even scratched the surface of stuff that we can create. I'll actually be using this more in future videos. There are so many other things that I have ideas for, but I just didn't have the time to create those for a video to come out this weekend. So you can create very basic projects like you just saw here, or something pretty elaborate. So we'll see what the future holds for this thing. It'll be fun. This was going to be my original piano, and the graphite from the sketching pencil was going to be my conductive material. I don't know if that would have worked, but I ended up going with aluminum foil piano keys. Thank you. So here I just wanted to show you that if you go to Google and you do a search for Makey Makey Games, and you scroll down here, you can click on Scratch Studio here, and there's a whole bunch of different games you can play. And a popular one here is Super Mario. And it'll load here. If you know how to create your own Scratch apps, that's helpful too. You can do anything you want. But since I don't, I can go here, and there's always a screen, or should be a screen, that tells you what buttons control the game. So we'll come over here and click Help. And it should tell us what controls that we need to use to map to our Makey Makey. And it looks like we need to map the arrow keys on our keyboard and the spacebar to our Makey Makey in order to play this game. And the game does look kind of cheesy, as you can see. It is a game, nonetheless. But you can also do other games that you play on your computer, so this is just one option. So as you can see, there are 30 games here, it says up here at the top. You can also, this is what I did, I went to Google and I typed in Scratch Instruments, and I found Scratch Studio, the instruments, and I used a piano right here with all the keys on it. And it told me exactly which keys that I needed to map to my Makey Makey. So this may be helpful for you if you're using the Makey Makey. There's all kinds of different instruments you can use, so keep that in mind. Or you can create your own through Scratch coding.
That's all I've got for now, and as always, thank you very much for watching. If you have one of these, let me know what you think about it. Let me know what you think about the video, and until next time, take care.